Hi friends, greetings from Jaipur and greetings from myself. We have done this SYLVIAN FISSURE DISSECTION course. This is a very rare occasion that the SYLVIAN FISSURE DISSECTION only particularly focused cadaveric dissection is very rarely been done. Even in the workshops, cadaveric workshops, many of them. And here the why I wanted to do cadaveric workshop of only SYLVIAN FISSURE opening dissection in cadavers, because it is the highway of the skull based surgery. If you know how to open, how safely you can open the SYLVIAN FISSURE, you can do a lot of surgeries, like even insular gliomas and aneurysms of the entire skull base and of the cellar, suprasellar, parasellar tumors, meningiomas of the sphenoid wing, and many more surgeries you can easily do, including epilepsy surgery. So here we have enjoyed a beautiful SYLVIAN FISSURE dissection. You can see our videos here, so please have a look on it.
Lift it a little bit, and under the high magnification you put a small incision into the arachnoid. And then once you put the
anterior point,
To the anterior sylvian point, you just don't cut it more, just put a small nick into that. If you start getting a release of CSF, this is okay. Otherwise put the seizure like this into that, don't do anything and just open it. So you will see whether there is something coming below, some artery or vessel or some connecting vein or something. If it is nothing there, then you can keep on opening it.
So no need for any assistant to
nothing.
Nothing.
I am alone.
No,
the retractor is only to hold later on, not now. You just wait here. Once you open this arachnoid, cut this. Now you can see there is a big sea of CSF is released here. Mm. Once it is released, just wait for here. Then you see which side is more wider SYLVIAN FISSURE. So you can keep on opening, if it is going here, the vein is going here, and it is open here, you can keep on dissecting like this. Hello? This is the way how you can do.
So that much then, you have to go?
Then you keep. Possibly. As much as possible you can, it depends on your pathology where you are going.
Okay.
So now you can see that I am not damaging anything even in cadaver.
Mm-hmm.
See, now if you have more high magnification, you can see there is an arachnoidal bands in between.
Mm-hmm.
Can you see that?
Yes.
You just look into them and then keep on cutting one by one. Very, very fine.
अगर सर ऐसे वेन आ जाए बीच में यू कैन कट दैट
यू हैव टू सी इट फर्स्ट डिसेक्ट द अरेक्नॉइड अराउंड दैट वेन नाउ यू कैन सी हाउ ब्यूटीफुल इट इज ओपनिंग ओके सो नाउ डोंट पुट एनी रिट्रैक्शन डू सम वेरी स्मॉल कीप ऑन आस्क योर असिस्टेंट कैन यू जूम इट एंड सी दैट देयर आर अरेक्नॉइडल फाइबर्स बिटवीन टेम्पोरल एंड पैरिटल फ्रंटल एंड टेम्पोरल कैन यू सी दैट कल वहां पे वो थे ना, वो डन स्पेशलाइज भी थे ना, वहां नहीं है क्या? मैंने बहुत सारे लाया था, उससे रिट्रैक्ट कर सकते हैं हल्का सा। और ये देखो कितना दिख रहा है ना, कितने भयंकर रीजन्स दिख रहे हैं ना बीच में। दीज आर अरेक्नॉइडल रीजन्स, देयर इज नथिंग यू आर गोइंग टू डैमेज, यू जस्ट हैव टू स्प्रेड इट। इधर देखो, ये इसको रिट्रैक्ट, इसको थोड़ा सा रिट्रैक्ट करोगे ना, ये देखो, यू कैन सी दीज अरेक्नॉइडल रीजन्स। फिर इनको धीरे से इनको खोलना है और बैठना है, ये देखो खुला, ये देखो, है ना? और यू कैन ओपन द सीजर ऑल्सो, देन यू कैन सी वेदर देयर इज समथिंग इम्पोर्टेंट और नॉट, राइट? सो दीज आर द अरेक्नॉइडल बैंड्स, हियर अगेन यू कम डाउन, वेयर यू फाइंड द स्पेस यू कैन कीप ऑन कटिंग, डोंट डैमेज एनी वेन, गो स्लोली. When the brain is angry red, fiery red, you can get distracted and then do that. So this is the main important area of the medial side, and if you go down, you can see the pons and the midbrain, and then you can see the
aqueduct here. Can you see aqueduct here? And this is the this part is the third ventricle. And what is this? Endothelamic adhesion. This very small fiber connections are between two thalamus. And here like also in all over the corpus callosum there are fibers which are called connection fibers or commutation fibers you can also. And here will be the, here is the point where you can find the posterior commutation. Right. And then this is the, this part is the colliculi. Can you see the
superior
and inferior? You can see both. Right. Can you see this? This is the optic chiasma. This is the right optic nerve. This is the left optic nerve which has been cut here. And this is the chiasma. And what is this? This is tiny structure. Stalk. This is the stalk here. Right. This was stalkectomy has been done. Right. And which is this artery? Which is this artery? Which artery is this? Can you tell me? This is basilar, is bifurcating into the PCA, right here. And this is giving the perforators here. You can see fine perforators giving to the, this basilar is was here. If we can see in the another, yeah, it is here. No, it's not here also, it was cut in between. So this is the midline, the spinal cord started. And here we have the basilar artery, which is here. You can see here. If you remove this optic pathways, this is here. Right. This is the basilar dividing into, by giving bifurcation into two PCA. If you see this at the base of the brain, this is the ICA, which has become supraclenoid artery. Supraclenoid ICA. So this is now becoming MCA, it is going into the sylvian fissure. You can see it very well.
Yes,
it is. This is the A1. This is the A1 going here. If this brain was on the left side, this looks like left hemisphere. So this is the left A1. And this left A1 is going here and it is becoming a cone. Can you see? It is becoming a cone. This is left A2. And this is right A2. And the right one will be the on the another hemisphere. So this is the A-com. And here you can see the A2 artery and then you can see the frontopolar artery. You can see this frontopolar artery, small frontopolar artery. And then it goes the callosal artery.
हम ज़्यादा worried रहते हैं.
तो arteries की anatomy अगर हमें बताया ये जैसे sylvian fissure अगर हम देखें तो AMCA यहाँ जाएगा. You know the Juhasz, this very focused approach for MCA bifurcation you can see here. Can you see it in the sylvian fissure here? This is the, what is this you know?
Optic trunk.
No,
sorry, olfactory trunk.
Yes. This is olfactory trunk, very beautifully coming here. And this is the MCA. And this is the MCA bifurcation. This is the frontal branch, this is the temporal branch. And this is the sylvian cistern. Once you open a sylvian cistern, you will have a flood of CSF. You will see that how much of CSF is here, and the brain will get relaxed. Right? And then the CSF, the MCA stem are vessels. MCA stem aneurysms are very rare. But although there are MCA stem aneurysms, I clipped 2 weeks ago one MCA stem aneurysm. Most commonly, we will have a bifurcation aneurysms. So, this is the frontal branch going here, and then this is the temporal branch going here. Now, we'll come to the medial side. You can see the callosal artery, callosal marginal artery, and these are the branches of the cingulate, pericallosal branches, cingulate going. Can you see this? Callosal marginal is, there are so many, they are called callosal marginal arteries. Right? So, like this, you can say this is, there are so many frontopolar branches. So, this, here, these branches comes into action when we have some olfactory groove meningioma. Olfactory groove meningioma get supply from the two ways. Like, one is the ethmoidal arteries. आपने A1 ट्रेस करी, आप A1 ट्रेस करते हो, सबसे पहले आप A1 को क्लीन करना आपको, and look around the A1 that you have completely denuded the A1 around that, from all around, because in case of temporary clipping, you can put it, in case of rupture when you need it, but I rarely use temporary clipping, I don't use because I don't like temporary clipping, So, but it depends on experience. Previously I used to. Now you go to A1 and keep on tracing the A1 along with the ipsilateral optic nerve. This is the distance between the optic nerve and the acom artery is how much? Optic nerve, how much? Do you know that? What is the diameter of IC here? What is the diameter of IC here? What is the diameter of IC here? They are very important points. You must know that. And once it goes MCA, then how much the size, diameter of the MCA is less than the ICA? And what is the size of the A1? Can you see? You see the A1 is almost 30% of the MCA. Or ye optic nerve ja rahi hai. So yahan pe kya hoga? Opticocarotid system. So aap thoda sa relax karoge until unless there is a very thick SH. Then put the suction and keep on putting the water. So it will relax. It will dissolve the blood, whatever it is there. So then once you see the membrane, thin membrane here, just put a bipolar, if you have a sharp bipolar or blunt bipolar, just put a bipolar here. हल्के से डालोगे और इसको खोल लोगे बाइपोलर ये फट जाएगी फिर शांति से बैठ जाओ
मोस्ट कॉमन इज द फ्लो इज हियर इफ द राइट साइड इज डोमिनेंट देन वेयर यू एक्सपेक्ट द एंड्रोजम इज लाइक दिस बिकॉज इट इज द एंड्रोजम नेक एंड एंड्रोजम फंडस विल ग्रो इन द पोजीशन वेयर द एक्चुअल ब्लड फ्लो शुड हैव फ्लोन बट इट इज डाइवर्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ द टर्न ऑफ द आर्टरी सो द then you will find the neck here so you have to separate the small perforators here this is the optic tract we have already told this
so what if we ligate the perforator along with the clip
ligation is not possible you have to coagulate you can coagulate so these are the two ACs going there is an aneurysm so then you have to see whether this aneurysm neck is where so with the blunt right angle dissector right with the right blunt right angle dissector you can dissect the neck around this is here you can dissect the neck here look for the neck here for here dissect it here very slowly it should not be sharp otherwise you can rupture the dome of the aneurysm so but sometimes because the patient's position is like this but actually the patient is in supine is like this so the aneurysms will be this you have to see it from above like most of these aneurysms you have to reach it to the neck is from here like you can see that put the light on here this is the place where the neck is actually in most of the aneurysms whether it is directing anteriorly anterior superiorly anterior inferiorly posteriorly posterior superiorly the most of these aneurysms arise from here this is the recurrent humeral which is going to the anterior perforator substratus
you have to go above this thing
ha kabhi wo to depend karta hai zyada tar a1 a2 junction pe aata hai maine photo dikhai thi na wo तो एक मेरे पास अभी फोटो निकल नहीं रही है आई हैव ऑपरेटेड वन इन रिकरेंट एब्डोमिनल एंड्रोजम सो दैट वाज कमिंग हियर और अभी तीन दिन पहले आई ऑपरेटेड वन एक एंड्रोजम एंड ही हैड द दिस थिंग रिकरेंट आर्टरी ह्यूमनर रिकरेंट ह्यूमनर आर्टरी इज इन फैक्ट दिस इज द पोजीशन वेयर द नेक इज राइट सो नाउ द हियर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट फ्रॉम वेयर द इफ यू can divide the acom what happens can you divide this if you no. put a clip here on both sides of the artery and you can divide it yeah. what happens
no, it will create deficit no,
no. nothing will happen until unless one is dominant that you have to see first in CT angio or DSA
co-dominant otherwise
if one is dominant another is there but if it is azygous like from one it is filling I'll show you one patient if it is from filling from one side and on CT angio or DSA the other A1 is not visualized not opacified then you cannot clip on the both side but otherwise you can clip if because sometimes in these acoms the neck is very friable And the most important thing here is the perforators coming posteriorly to the hypothalamus. If patient is having SH and his sodium is 130 or less, you can say he has a hypomagnesemia. There is no other diagnosis.
Well, I didn't get that, sir. You said if a patient is having
SH rising from their ECOM, and I have just shared my one of the this is the oncus portion, oncus, medial temporal lobe, right? This herniates and this blocks here the third nerve and does the pupillary dilatation, which we see here. So now if you have time, I can dissect the whole optic tract and everything, like all tracts. But we need a patience and time. If we, the way I am doing is not the good way, but just to show you in lack of time. Now we have entered the temporal hole. Can you see that? I have entered the temporal hole. So
your optic tract
radiations are
ready.
आप कितने डिग्री पे रखते हो हेड को?
20
दिस इज ऑन लेफ्ट साइड राइट राइट सो जैसे आपने सिल्वियन फिशर रिलैक्स किया ना आप यहाँ पहुंच जाओगे सीधा है ना तो आपके असिस्टेंट को सिर्फ ये बोलना है कि यार इसको छोटा टेम्पल लोब को हटा के रखना है बीच में नहीं आए कॉटन लगा के लगा लो नाउ यू विल गेट आई सी ए एंड दिस इज द ऑप्टिक नर्व यू कैन सी फुल स्ट्रक्चर हियर दिस इज द एम से ब्रांचेस गोइंग इन टू द
Yeah,
can somebody cut it, so I can...
When we do trans-Sylvian approach for VG blade...
Can you see? What is this? What is coming from here like this? Frontal horn, body of the ventricles. Can you see ventricle?
Yeah, yeah.
What man you are talking? See?
Wow.
Can you see it?
Yes.
See this?
Yeah.
This beautiful creature of the God. See now, this is posterior, this body of the lateral ventricle, and this is the posterior, and this is the occipital horn. Now, we can connect it with the posteriorly here. Can you see it?
Yes.
Now see, this is the lateral ventricle. Okay. Mm-hmm. So the what I was talking about, the recurrent humor coming here through the this thing, perforator substance, and this is the caudate nucleus here, medial to the internal capsule. First, this is insula, then external capsule, then internal capsule.
Okay, from exterior to interior.
Right. So, this is insula of which we are afraid of. So, if you see the frontal hole, and if you look into here, what is this? Elevations are, they are the caudate nucleus.
Frontal capsule is below the lateral ventricle.
Yes.
Pushing the lateral ventricle.
Yes. So basically, if leave it just a minute, most of the basal ganglia bleed is actually here, inside the insula in here, and lateral to the temporal horn comes down here like, and then you should go from the cortex. I would not suggest to go through the sulcus, because you are going to damage more in the sulcus. This is the optic nerve in chiasma, and this is optic
tract.
Right. So then if you want me to dissect the radiation, I can dissect and show you beautifully. So this is beautifully seen here, the choroid plexus coming from the body of the ventricle to the temporal horn. And this is the hippocampus. You can see beautifully, and the fimbria here. Now in epilepsy surgery, it depends on that how much is involved. You can dissect it, you can cut it, and you can feel it. If there is a more hard, you can remove it till there, because the optic radiations are not here. It is like you can cut with the bipolar from here, as I am cutting it with the spatula.
Dented virus ye rahega na ye iske niche
abhi khol ke dikha denge isko katenge and we'll remove it, you can see it.
Yeah.
Okay.
they change from
very person to person.
Yeah. But you can grossly see that. Don't go towards the ventricle, because you can, if there is no interventricular bleed, you will make it interventricular bleed. So just lateral to it and medial to insula.
Either. This brain is a little bit mutilated, but still you can see. Grey matter, alag se dikh raha na? Ye white matter dikh raha hai, alag se. The consistency and the color.
क्या बोलते हैं इसको?
Olfactory cortex और
entorhinal cortex है ना? यहाँ ही होती है ना ये? यहाँ से आ रहा है ना ये? ये देखो, ये optic tract आ रहा है, olfactory आ रहा है ना? ये if you go here, ये तो मुझे out of syllabus चीज करा रहे हो?
हैं? Next time सब organize करेंगे पहले
book. See this. We don't have that much of light. We need an OT light. This is optic olfactory. You should have this action filling. We have done and then this is the occipital lobe. They have to reach here.
Yeah.
So they will be fanning out here like this. Here. So if you want me to dissect this only, then I can dissect it at some other time.
So whenever it's coming on the superior part of the temporal
part. Medial part.
Medial part of the temporal part.
Not the superior part. So this is what, this is how it is going like. Here the, in front of the, this thing, optic radiations, what is this? Crura.
Crura, yeah.
So the optic radiation, also not optic radiation, but the corona radiata becomes the, crust and crust cerebri comes into here and becomes here like that, and then it becomes the midbrain, right? So this is how you can do, this is how you can dissect. Can you lift it so I can cut it? So okay, that is the deeper structure. First we will talk about the insula. This is the thin arachnoid, you can see the, this is the ependymoma, you can see. Right. So this is the, so this is the part where, from where we are afraid of. This is the insula. What is the meaning of insula in English? Literary meaning?
Island.
Yes. Actually, island is called isla in Latin. So it is called insula in some Portuguese language or something. So this is the concentrated fiber of the, from this is the crust, this is lateral to the crust, yeah. The insula, this is crust coming here, can you see medial to the optic radiations,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
There is a crust, mm-hmm. Crust which the coronal radiata has part, yeah. Right, and then if you go a little bit superiorly, you can see that there is an insula, so this insula is again the connecting fibers, like we have the frontal lobes, very few fibers which are coming in from all over it and concentrating it here. So the insula is here, then there is an internal capsule, and then inter capsule makes the fibers more concentrated like a bouquet. You can see the bouquet is above, it is wide, then it comes down, the flower bouquet which I got it this morning, same thing, right. So before that I would like to describe this. Sometimes I can show you the U fibers which are the in this insula, in the, not in the insula, but you can see the fibers here. I can dissect. No, just fistus.
Okay.
Wait. You can see the gray matter fibers are here, U fibers. These are called the U fibers in the sulcus, in the gyrus. Right? So that you can do it. These are fibers like coming here. So, and if you go there, if you do the dissection, if you want me to remove the vessels. Beautiful picture. Going here and this is here. Right. Look at how beautiful it is.
This is the entorhinal cortex.
Yes. It is going here, like in here.